skunks with rabies. In the last 2 weeks, the Department of Natural Resources says there have been multiple reports in the state. Reporter Peter Curry shows us why the DNR says it might be a good idea to keep a shovel handy.
We all know that smell. It's unmistakable. Now, with confirmed cases of rabid skunks near Detroit, I talked with Brian Roll today, a wildlife biologist with the DNR, about the risks of rabies in the UP.
This time of year, bats are winding down. They're starting to hibernate, so you probably won't be seeing bats anymore. It is possible for skunks and raccoons still to be carrying it. It is kind of getting late in the season.
Roll tells me he's not aware of any positive rabies cases in the UP. I asked him what to do if someone thinks they are exposed.
If there is a human exposure, they should not call the DNR. They should call the Marquette County Health Department and work through them if you think there was a human exposure. And that would include anything, you know, if you have an infant in a room and you find a bat, you should still treat that as a possible exposure just because you don't know.
Roll says that it has been more than 10 years since there has been any positive rabies cases in Marquette County, but to pay attention to wild animals and their behavior.
If you see a sick animal, I mean, they should all be treated as a possible carrier, particularly if it's a skunk or a raccoon or a bat. They can carry it and they can even look healthy. That's why we recommend that you do not handle live animals, or, and if you do handle a dead animal, handle it with a shovel or something like that if you're going to try to dispose of it.
While you have your phone in your hand, go to upmatters.com. I put a couple of links to resources around the state when it comes to rabies. Reporting from Marquette County, I'm Peter Curry, Local 3 News.
Okay, Peter, thank you.